and have a look. Come on, come and have a look.
Six of you have just counted. Last man, the partner's back. Last man, the partner's back. Come on, money up.
Another one planned down there, like a normal box. What does the different shapes of boxes give them the option to do? Those different shapes. What are they practicing? Different what?
Different angles of passes.
Angles, different angles of passes, different movements. Just due to a little bit of organisation, rather than having like four squares, now we've got like a diamond there, look. The triangle and like a rectangle here. That one was a box, but I don't necessarily have to use that now. All so I've just got them started off, bread and butter, all in. Go on then, play. Man to your right goes in. Simple as. So my conditions have enabled me to let them go on then, play. Bit of fun, whatever you want to do, ownership of it. We're just bang, go. Okay? Now I may go in and coach a little bit here if I wanted to as a coach. I may do. Wait, what could I look for in these little drills here?
Ownership, the way they're receiving the ball.
Good, anything else?
First touch.
You've got loads to work on now. Okay, loads of stuff to work on. Passes, weight to passes, anything. Now remember, if I was a coach, I'd be going around looking at them. What's the problem I've got as a coach though now? If I want to deal with this group as it's what? Yeah, I'm all spaced out, aren't I, really? In anticipation of having like 2-11s or 2-12s. So I've got a little bit of tinkering to do now to give them some information. Come on, what can we do? Give me some key points. If I want to bring them all in now and give them a key point, what could it be? You as a coach now. One key point, two key points. Come on. What else may be on what? What must we do? And keep the ball what? You want it moving, don't you? Okay, have a look at this. Last one in! Last one in! Hurry up! Come on! Quickly, last one in! Okay, well done. All you've got to look to do now, stay in the same area. If you give it away, the man to your left goes in. Okay? Man to your left. The only other condition is if the ball stops still when you're passing it, you go in and the man to your left goes in. Have you got that?
Yeah.
You're live, go on, play. Put it up quickly, last one in, the box is in! Last one in! So, the condition now, if you don't move the ball, right, you're going in. You're going in. But that's what I want them to do. Once again, I haven't really gone in and coached. I've brought them all in. Now I'll give them a condition. Now, when in your position, I may go and observe. Come on then, is the ball moving? So my condition's got it moving. Keep going, well played, come on, quickly go, play. come on, let's go, play, go! When you're live, go, play!
Played. What was good about that? Well, what was good about it? What was the ball doing? Very quickly. Well done. Okay. What else may you do on a football pitch?
Move.
Fantastic. So this time, when you've passed it, try and move along one of your lines. So you've got a box there, you've got a triangle there, and you've got a diamond. So this time, once you've passed it, still moving the ball, look to move along your line, whatever it may be. Got it?
Yeah.
And it's man to your right if you give it away. You're live, go on, back in. Go on, play, quickly, come on. Hurry up, don't be last. The mistake, the guy over there just hits a side foot, this guy in the air with a bad pass. The problem I faced as a coach, he goes in the middle. I can't actually recreate that coaching style with him because he's gone in the middle. So just bearing in mind, you can put a time allocation on it, okay, he's in for a minute. It may then give you the opportunity to coach the boys, but it, concentrate, you're passing the ball again. Body over the ball, pass. Do you want to have another go? Off you go. So another coaching style, but the problem you face, because I've said they're going in, it may rob me the opportunity to say, well, I need to coach you there. And you're in the room. But you know what I mean? Captain, to the next area, take ownership. Exercise, come on. Exercise, Captain. Exercise! Well done! They've got the ball moving. You can tinker with it how you see fit. There's a couple of conditions. Moving the ball, moving your body along your line, and then just stuck a little bit of competitiveness into it, respect the 10 passes. You get them at it. You may need to go around the G up. Remember, I'm doing you guys more so than them, shall we say.
respect for coach education. For you guys as coaches, things we can talk about here. Rates of passes, different types of passes, movements, within either still or normal. Okay, the next phase, I've got a massive problem right now. Why have we got a massive problem? So I've only got 17 with two keepers. So snooping to a certain degree and respecting 11 here. What can I do? Flags out.
Yeah.
So we could use corner flags. Okay, we want to do a little bit of shape though. So how could it involve all the team in shape?
Or two teams,
V2
plus one,
depending on the other. Or we could, what else though? Come on. Could add a few floating defenders against it. So floating defenders or double up in the shape. And I'd change the piece out of it. A few things to think about now. You as coaches, you plan for something, you plan for 11v11. Oh my god, yeah, I can't do it. So, double up. Local defenders, things like that. Okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll let them. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to double up. So you're all, like, we've got 11. Rotate with a man alongside, just have to turn the piece and doing it. Rather than having five floating around being defending, we're just going to double it up. Okay? Everyone got that? Yeah? Two goalies, where are you? Okay. You have turned the piece, you'll start the session off. You're going to feed it into the halfway line from that area. You're attacking against the wind. matchup in relation to how many players got in the end? Float around, so we'll just shadow each other to a certain degree. now, we want to get training as close to match realism, don't we? As close, remember it's unopposed. Now, there's the way you can do that. Stop, stand still. Whatever it may be. But if we're going to attack, i.e. 30, 40 yards off from the opponent's goal, what does it need to be?
Let's go! Come on!